story.
Hi everyone, welcome to your March Alchemy Scope. So let's take a look and see what is the macro cycle, what is the narrative that is underpinning the energy set and the growth cycle for all of us, for the collective. So to do that, we look at the Sabian symbol, and this month's new moon is also an annular solar eclipse, and it's happening at 8 degrees 12 minutes Pisces on the 26th of February 2017. At that point, the Sabian symbol is a jockey spurs his horse, intent on outdistancing his rivals. So if we look at the keynote for this particular symbol, we have intense mobilization of energy and skill in the drive for success in any social performance affected by the competitive spirit. This is talking about every superfluous weight, every unnecessary consideration is to be dismissed in the one pointed attempt to reach one's social goal. One of the keywords for this symbol is self-quickening. So let's take a look. That's the energy for all of us. The collective is going through a self-quickening portal of evolution. Okay, and again, the keynote for this symbol, intense mobilization of energy and skill.
Hi, Taurus.
In the drive for success in any social performance affected by the competitive spirit. Okay, so let's take a look and see what is the specific narrative for your particular sign.
Taurus, welcome to your March alchemic evolutionary journey. What is the narrative that's unfolding for you? So as I've been doing since the start of 2017, we have two forms here, square and circle. Please tune in to the one that resonates for you the most. Which one are you drawn to? That's the message that is really speaking to you over the course of the cycle. Now, these are representing a bifurcated path for Taurus. So Taurus is on an evolutionary pathway. This is what I have been picking up for a while now about a bifurcation that's occurred. They're two branches of the same path. Oftentimes they are the same messages but nuanced differently. Sometimes they're a little bit different. It really depends on what's activated in the moment for your ego journey, for your ego maturation journey. So while you tune into that, I'm going to go ahead and choose the Carolyn Mace archetype card Growth Edge for your circle and the square branch of your path. Again, choose one. One is speaking to you more than the other. So four squares. It's the Growth Edge for Taurus. Squares. March. Okay, and circles. Circles. Okay, lovelies. So let me go ahead and we'll peek at them now and then we'll talk about them. Interesting. Dilettante's come up before, several times actually. Liberator for squares, dilettante for circles. And we'll talk about those after we look at the readings. Okay. So go ahead and put the video on pause if you need more time. Otherwise, I'll do the reveal. And what I'd love to do is I'm going to bring the candle down here, just to have it present on the table, and then I'll bring up all the cards so you're going to be able to see them all. Okay, so let's start with the squares, okay? The yellow bordered cards are the Bral Talej deck from Damon here. I'll put the link below in the description. The white bordered cards are my own Siri deck. There's only one deck. I made it for myself many years ago. People have asked if it's for sale, and unfortunately it's not. I don't have copyright on this, on the photographs. And the tarot card in the middle is the Druidcraft. So let's take a look. Now, I will tell you that there's kind of a crunchy message here. So there's some stuff activated for Tauruses. Now, a lot of Tauruses aren't going to like to hear what this has to say because you've already been through so much. I will tell you, though, that I have hope because I just finished a mid-month scope for my patrons, and it was a delicious opening. There's something opening, starting anew for Taurians. It is happening, okay? But the messages that I'm getting for the March cycle for you, the Pisces new moon cycle for Tauruses, is interesting. So let's look at what's coming up. First of all, the Two of Wands is coming up for the squares. So Taurus squares, this is about planning with regards to looking ahead for the future and what you need to create for yourself to get the logistics in place. This is a planning card. And interestingly, underneath it, so kind of the sub-story to planning is negativity, feeling negative about the quickness of what you need to have come to pass. So there's an experience of negativity, pessimism or worry or stress, anxiety, with regards to something that's happening very quickly. This is like the Eight of Wands card. There's stuff happening quickly. And for you, it has to do with planning. So a lot of you are manifesting something new in your reality, and it's happening fast, and it's creating some anxiety, okay? So that's kind of the center card, the center message for this portal of time for you. Now, at the base, you're going to have, you're wanting a path forward. You're wanting to proceed, and you're having some doubts. See, I think the deception card that's coming up in the foundational sector is talking about doubts. So because things are happening quickly and you have some negativity showing up for you with regards to, oh my God, there's a lot to do. There's an overwhelm there. For you, you're having doubts around you pushing forward. But it's all coming from, let's say, the negativity that's happening, or the negativity around the bulk of work that you have to do. I have a feeling there's a lot for you to do in March, and it's causing doubt. The deception card for you is about doubt. And this is about your soul journey. So you're questioning, you're insisting on soul alignment journey. You're insisting on doing what feels good to you, what is right for you. It's all good, right? But you're also going into that doubt around it. Like, oh my gosh, was this the right decision? That's what I get. But your thought, your mind is going to be focused on, okay, what is it? What is it that I am aligned with right now? What is really in my best good, in my higher good, in my aligned good? And the interesting thing here is that you're going to be feeling positive. You're going to be feeling a sense of goodness. You're resonating at some level with a decision that you've made and all of this insisting on a new path forward and all the work that's entailed. You're feeling, at some level, you're feeling bliss around it, okay? But interestingly, with regards to your path, you're having some experience of challenge or difficulty with it. So again, I don't think this is a bad message at all or a negative message. I think that there is a lot that you have to do and it's creating some stress and anxiety, and that there's going to be some challenge that you're going to have to deal with, some little obstacle here and there over the course of March in order for you to get from point A to point B. And that's the second time I've used that term for these readings so far. So a lot of you are embarking on new journeys. That's what I want to say, not just Taurians, but other signs as well. So there's new things that are in the works for a lot of people, okay? Or it's imminent for a lot of you out there. Now look at this. Your growth edge is Liberator. That's what you need to work on, mature, and evolve this month. Liberator for you is about moving out of imposing your own will or tyranny over those you claim to liberate and ignoring legitimate constraints. okay? Ignoring legitimate constraints. Liberator is about maturing and evolving, freeing yourself and others from outmoded beliefs, releasing negative thought patterns. This is a main key for a lot of you out there because, again, we got the no, never card and the difficulty. So it's like there's a perception and experience that a lot of you are going to be having, the squares, with regards to challenge, obstacle. But challenge and obstacle is part of any new adventure. So if you can change your perception, you can release the resistance to it. It should be this way. It should be that way. I'm a good person. Why do bad things happen, etc.? It's the resistance to the process that's causing the stress. And again, the no never card is coming up in the middle. That's talking about anxiety and worry, etc. So Liberator, release and change, shift your negative thought patterns. Now, interestingly, for the circles, this is what's coming up. First of all, the High Priestess is coming up in the center. This, of course, is about accessing your power, your feminine power, your intuitive power, your connection to the unconsciousness, to the source field. Underneath that is more fear. There's fear around your femininity. There's fear around your intuition. There's fear around your power. As a woman, for those of you that are men watching, it's around your intuition. For those of you that are women watching, this is about you as woman. A lot of this is the big collective emergence now. This is the evolution of the feminine on a very big level. For a lot of circles out there, Taurus circles, you're going to be challenged. There's more, you have some fear. That is, by the way, very valid. It's very valid, very natural, just part of your process. But you are going to be moving through some fear around how powerful am I? What is real? What is true? How deeply connected to my powerful intuition am I? You know, so around how you feel power, how you experience power, how you actualize and catalyze power. That's the core for the circles. Now, just like for the squares, there is the darkness card coming up in the spiritual sector. This is talking about a dark night of the soul. This is talking about negative spiritual growth experiences. It's talking about having challenging understandings or beliefs or experiences about the difficulty and the challenges of the spiritual growth experience. I just went through that. I continue to go through it. We all go through it. This is about having some challenging spiritual experiences of late. And guess what? You bet it's happening. It's been happening. There's big, big, big evolution called now, and it's challenging, okay? Precious is coming up, the Precious card, and the Appreciation card is coming up. So there's something that a lot of circles are going to be going through in the month of March, okay, that has to do with feeling angry, having darkness around appreciation for the spiritual lessons. So there's some doubt, cynicism, frustration, bitterness, anger that's coming up around having appreciation for our spiritual growth experiences, period. Okay. And again, with the fear card coming up in the center, which is directly related to your power, you better believe that's going to be a big dark night of the soul. This is about you emerging into a big you, the biggest you. Now, at the base for you is the right card. Now, the writing card is about self-expression, not just about writing. It could be about speaking, just speaking your truth, just speaking what is true for you. For some of you, this is going to be about writing. It's going to be about communications, okay? So at the base for you, over the course of the month, there's some level of challenge and fear about speaking your truth, okay? Again, fear is here, your power is here, and it has to do with communications. So that's going to be a main theme. Now, it's going to be an emotional month. March might be yet another emotional month for Tauruses. So it might be that some of the darkness and the bitterness that's experienced with having any sense of appreciation for what's going on with your life, it's going to trigger deep feelings. So let the feelings flow this month. Let it come. Let it be. Honor it. Honor what's coming. There's no accident with the portal, the chapter of your growth that has to do with negativity coming up. So let the negativity be. Don't resist it. It's not that you should be in another place. That's where you're at. So allow it to be. Honor it. And I have to tell you guys, this is interesting. So in the mental sector, you're getting the hope card. So you're going to be having thoughts around hope. Do you have it? Do you not? Are you still hopeful for the future, et cetera? So hope, hiding. Hiding, my darlings, is talking about the right card. See, right is at the base, and this combination of cards is at the top. You're going to have some thoughts around how you've hidden your true expression, okay? And hope, hiding, return and revisit now. So there's something that is, you're hopeful that, gosh, you know what I think this is? I think what this is saying is that you want to hide. So it might be that you're thinking about, I just want to return to a space of being a hermit. I just want to return to a space of not being seen. I just want to return to a space of safety. The world right now is moving into exponential chaos mode. And what that means is that there's a lot unleashed in the human psyche and in the manifest reality that we live in. So you might hope for hiding. You might hope to retreat back into yourself and return into yourself now. So over the course of March, I think that because of the fear, because of the dark night of the soul that might be activated, or, and by the way, this is a general reading. It's not going to apply to everybody, but this is we're tapping into general narratives that are playing out for your growth and evolution. There is something there, everybody. Now let's take a look at this. Now, the growth edge for you over the course of the cycle is dilettante. Dilettante is an interesting one. So down at the base, the shadow attribute, what wants to be evolved out of, is pretension to much deeper knowledge than you actually possess. Okay? It's pretending that you know more than you do. What wants to be evolved with dilettante is delighting in the arts without having to be a professional. No degree. There's no need for anything. You are an artist. Everybody's an artist. So this is about just delighting in the creative process. Just do it. Be it, you know? And here, it's about alerting you to the danger of becoming superficial in your pursuits. Now, I will tell you, with the writing card at the bottom and with dilettante coming up, for a lot of you, this is going to have to do with writing, blogging, creating videos, creating novels, short stories, whatever it is. But for a lot of you, because dilettante is talking specifically about you as the artisan, and because communications is coming up, this could definitely just have to do with self-expression, but it could also have to do with expression via artistic modes and modalities. This is saying the growth edge for the circles is love yourself, honor yourself, love that you are nature, and nature just creates. It is a creative source field. Let the impulse move through you. You don't need to know anything. You don't need to know more than you do. You know exactly the perfect thing right now, right here. So just let it move you. Be moved by the creative impulse. That's what this is about. And by the way, when you do that, when you let your creativity flow, you better believe that this negativity in the spiritual sector is going to transmutate. You better believe it is, right? And you better believe that the fear that you're feeling, experiencing with regards to this, your beautiful power, you better believe that that's going to transmutate, right? Let the creativity flow. Now, Taurus, for the squares and for the circles, I have also pulled your I Ching narrative, as I've done, for the last 2 years. And I have pulled your Dakini embodiment. Who are you to become over the course of this month to ride it with least effort? So who are you archetypally to become and step into for the circles to deal with the fear? And who are you, the squares, to become and step into to deal with the negative thought processes? So it's to go to the library. This is your library. You can go to thealchemyofholism.com/library. And for those of you that want to order a reading or your soul print package or whatever it is, one of the many services that I offer, you can also find all the details in that link as well. So Taurus, I do send you much love for a powerful March portal, and I'll see you on the other side. Bye.